using this general transport equation, we can now look at conservation of mass. We can derive it from this equation. So we are interested in the conservation of mass inside of a control surface from this Eulerian perspective. So we can apply this general transport equation, but what we need is phi. We need to define phi, which is this property per unit mass. Well, if we're looking at conservation of mass, mass per unit mass is equal to 1 for this scenario. So now we can just plug this right into that equation. So what we'll get is del rho dt plus del dot rho v equals, and g is our generation or destruction term. Mass cannot be generated or destroyed, so that's got to be equal to 0. So this is our general conservation of mass equation, and we can simplify this if we say if it's an incompressible fluid, which we're going to spend most of our time in this course looking at incompressible fluids, and so if the fluid is incompressible, then you can actually do a few things. So that means that the density, let's just write this out here, incompressible, then d rho dt is equal to 0. And so that leaves us with just the other half of this equation here. So we have del dot rho v equals 0. Well, del dot, we can move, because rho is a constant, we can move that outside of this derivative here. And then because of the constant, we can divide it to the right hand side. And so what we're left with is del dot v equals 0. So this is the general conservation of mass equation for an incompressible fluid. But in general, this is the conservation of mass equation.